Talk about the Bautista siblings, just to get an idea of what kind of family this is. Because so you're saying that you have this accumulated wealth as a family.
That's
Let's talk about the siblings. How many are you? What are the profession?
Anim. Si Susan is the managing director of Bantay Bata. Gabby is a realtor in the United States. Ako'y pangatlo, doctor. Yung asawa ko, pulmonologist. Number four is chairman. Number five is Jose, who's a lawyer. His wife is also a lawyer. Number six is Tinin Tiongko, who's a lawyer. Mm-hmm. Abogado rin yung kanyang asawa, si Greg Tiongko. So kami puro mga professionals. And I want you to understand that ito amin, pinaghirapan namin to. Ako nag-aral after Ateneo grade school, Ateneo high school, 16 years straight. 4 years of zoology sa UP, 5 years of medical school, 3 years of residency training, 3 years of fellowship training, and then I taught for 1 year in the University of Downstate. So 16 years. Kami nagtatrabaho. Every day po yun.
Okay. Now, let's talk about these properties because there's this allegation that he owns a condominium unit in the district in San Francisco. Is this true?
It is. He co-owns that with my sister.
Which sister?
Who was based there. Susan.
Okay.
Was based in San Francisco for the longest time.
Okay.
So I don't know what his part is, ha?
Mm-hmm.
Hindi natin alam kung ano yung parte niya doon.
Okay. Now, how about this condominium unit in, for example, Juan Bonifacio, High Street?
Hindi ko alam yan. Pero it might be his. Pero he told me, he assured me, tell them yung Sal & Co. is going to coincide with whatever I told them.
Mm.
Because alam mo, Christian, matagal na rin tayo magkakilala. Sinabi ko sa kapatid ko yon, alam mo, corruption, masama yan, di ba? So I told him, alam mo kung totoo to, magpakamatay ka.
That's what you told him?
Yung sinabi ko sa kanya, sepuku ang tawag namin mga hapon.
What did he say?
Sabi niya, wala. And I believe my brother.
But you know, the problem is, judging by what happened during the Corona impeachment trial, there's really no such thing as a perfect Sal & Co. So you can always find a mistake.
That's right.
But certain misdeclarations.
He is that confident that he will not misdeclare. And that's why I'm here, to back him up.
But when can we expect the family, for you, for example, to present these details, these documents, at least those which are in your possession,
that's right,
in the family's possession, just
Christian,
to clear things up?
Alam mo, I was so tempted to bring them today dahil kilala kita. Pero I realized, yung kanilang proof, evidence, wala rin naman silang pinapakita, puro mga papel.
Mm.
Di ba? Hindi namin alam if these are fabrications. Hindi natin alam which one is genuine, which one is fake.
I think one of the more serious allegations coming from the estranged wife is the alleged allegation that he received commissions.
That's right.
From the lawyer of Smartmatic.
You don't report that to a newspaper or the media.
Mm.
Let Secretary Aguirre determine. Let the DOJ determine. Let BIR determine. Yan ang hinihiling lang. Complete unadulterated transparency.
Mm.
Wala kaming tinatago, walang ninakaw ang kapatid ko. This should not taint the elections. This should not cast any doubt on the outcome of the elections. Walang dayan doon.
Now, as a family, are the Bautistas planning to file a separate case against Patricia?
Alam mo, this is such a mess that right now I'm here to do two things. To protect my brother and nephews who are suffering right now. I mean, they're permanently scarred, but we have to mitigate that. And to make sure that we Filipinos have to safeguard our electoral process. That's one thing. Alam mo, huwag tayo magsisiraan, especially about the elections, because ito mga chismis natin, si Robredo tuloy naging vice president dahil sa kapatid ko. That's a complete lie. Let us not destroy our country by putting these... Wala naman, puro chismis yun. Unsubstantiated. To think, can a commissioner of the elections really change the outcome? I don't think so.
I'd like to talk about Patricia. What kind of person she is, as far as you know. You are a brother-in-law.
Yes, yes. Mm. And we've never had any conflict. We've never had any conflict. And I will never badmouth my sister-in-law. Mm. Never. I mean, she's the mother of my four nephews. And she's always been good. Ngayon, hindi ko alam whatever happened. It happens.
But let's talk about the facts. The allegation coming from your brother is that Patricia had a relationship with another man. Is that true?
Well, I have to be very honest with you there. Alam mo, and kapatid ko si chairman. Pero it's not about sex. It's about telling the public that I have a soulmate. Mas masakit sa akin yun, alam mo? Let have an affair, but by all means, wag mo naman sasabihin ka soulmate ko, hindi husband ko. Mas masakit sa akin yung
Christian. That's what she told.
Yeah, I mean, soulmate. She found a soulmate and she told it to Andy. Mm. Masakit yun. But my brother is not like me. I'm very, very passionate. He allowed it to happen to protect his kids, who at that time, I mean, ang bata nung bunso nila, 3 or 4.
When did this happen?
2013.
And then she left the conjugal home?
No, they still continue to inhabit the same unit in Pacific Plaza.
And then how did the chairman actually try to mend things?
He tried. Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know how he tried, but he tried. Mm-hmm. And he stayed in the marriage. He stayed in the marriage. That's the most important. He never wanted out. Mm-hmm.
Now, how has this controversy affected the family? For example, before we go into the kids, how about the siblings, your parents?
My mother is going to die earlier because of this. And I can tell that to you because I'm a physician. She had a stroke a couple of years ago. And I know, I mean, she told me, I only have tears and prayers at this point in my life. And mamamatay na mas maaga yung nanay ko because of this. But that's a fact that we have to accept.
But she is aware of the gravity of the allegations against the son.
Yun ang masakit nga dito, Christian. My father worked in the government. My grandfather was a judge. Wala kaming bahid. Hindi kami nagnanakaw. This is the most painful way to hit my family. This is the most effective way to hit my family. Yung bang babahiran kami ng corruption, bahol yan. Kaya nga, nung tumakbo ko ng kapatiran 2007, tumakbo ko sa Senado 2010, I told them, one term lang, at hindi, I'm going to forgo my salary. Mm. Dahil, kumita na kami. My brother, Chairman Andy, expresses that to all his students. Kitahin niyo muna yung pera niyo bago kayo magsilbi.
Now, there's also this impression that perhaps someone else, someone bigger, is working behind the scenes.
Ako, grabe.
Does the family also subscribe to that idea?
Alam mo, at this point, marami talaga. Pero hindi na natin alam eh. Hindi na natin alam. And at this point, I'm here to protect Chairman. And the integrity of the elections, alam mo, sa akin, mahalagang mahalaga yun na walang pandarayang nangyari sa eleksyon. Mm-hmm. That would be really do my country, our country, a disservice. Na si Chairman pala, nangumisyon para si Vice President.
Now, let's go to the possible impeachment case to be filed against the Chairman.
Yes.
Of course, there's already another one submitted by lawyer Oliver Lozano, but to the Office of the Ombudsman.
Yes.
So let's say that there's an actual impeachment complaint filed and endorsed before the House of Representatives. You as a brother, is this something that you would encourage him to face head on or just go away quietly?
Christian, personally kasi, go away quietly is the easier option. Easiest option. Alam mo, I am completely 100% sure Secretary Aguirre will find nothing. NBI will find nothing. Pero alam mo, mabigat ang impeachment. And my brother himself admitted, kung kami lang, 100% yan. Pero ako ngayon, 100%. Sabi ko kay Andy, tuloyin natin to.
And what did he tell you?
Let the chips fall.